T-shirt. I am Parashara Kumarpur from 6 Lab 5, number 18. Today I'm going to report the news named Unity View Backers Faith Court Order. MP fears verdict could spell Pertai's doom. Post reporters. The Constitution Court has ordered the 416 lawmakers and cabinet ministers who vote in support of Sharia amendment drafts to justify their decision. Citrix have slammed the move as an attempt to mirror with the registrar's authority. In a statement came after the Sharia Court accept the Yellow Shirt co-leader Jamlaw Singh's petition questioning if the Sharia rewrite proponents might have well laid. Section 68. Section 68 involves the upholding of democratic rule with the king as head of state and a lower judicial intervention in the case where an attempt to overthrow the constitutional monarchy suspect. Those ordered to give statements were 305 government MPs. 25 senator cabinet members and the House Speaker. They have 15 days to submit their statements. Constitution Court spokesman Somrit Taiwong said the court wants to hear the statements to decide if Jamlong's petition should be combined with five complaints that also question the legality of the Charter Amendment Bill. Mr. Somrit said, it is not known at this date when it will be issued after the court's two-day inquiry tomorrow and Friday. Pertai MP and legal expert Pirapan Panusak yesterday decried the Sharia Court of accepting the Yellow Shirt leader's complaint. He said, the move comes despite criticism and the court has no authority to accept such a petition directly. Mr. Pirapan said, the court has set a new and precedent the burdens, empowers and delegates a bit to figure on word of legislature. He said, a ruling against Pirapan would spell it doom. The opposition will pick up from there and ask to the anti-graft agency to impeach the charter amendments supporters. He said, it's unclear if charter court will also consider disbanding political parties if they are found guilty of breaching Section 68.
Prime Minister Thaksin Shinawatra has urged Popular Thai to accept the Charter Court's decision to keep the country intact. Popular Thai MP Grian Sak. He said Thaksin believed the Charter Court had no agenda and would rule based on the rule of the law. Mr. Grian Sak said the old Prime Minister also recommended the party back. Now from the reconciliation bill, if the issue intensifies political tension, if things aren't ready, he said, the bill should be delayed. It won't hurt, he said. First, I MP and Rachel leader Gaw Kao, Thikun Thong said, the Rachels were unlikely to back down if a ruling led to impeachment of government MPs, voting in favor of the Charter rewrite. But we will do it within the scope of the law to keep the government from trouble, he said. The Constitution Court will today finalize the list of witnesses from both sides who will testify in the two-day hearing. However, two potential witnesses yesterday denied being approached to testify. Hai Boon, a member of the National Human Rights Commission, said he was unaware of being called as a witness. Kanchanarat, advisor to the administration court, said she had never been approached. Thank you.